Good afternoon, everybody. The two last sessions of the day, which I think are both quite interesting in a very different way. And the first session, a short session I will present, is about reference data. Reference data for payments. How good is your reference data? How complete is your reference data? Well, why did I insist on presenting this here? In fact, what I did notice that here in India, for some reason it always jumps ahead, many banks still use the paper big directory. So it's like the phone book with all the bigs and information. Many of you still use it or use a big file. But if you think about doing correct payments, you need so much more. For specifically, standard settlement instructions. If you want to know the Australian dollar correspondent of a certain bank there, China Everbright Bank. But yes, you can ask them, but it's a cumbersome process. Ideally, you have it immediately. Are you certain when you have an IBAN and a BIC towards one of the IBAN countries, are you certain it's correct? Is the IBAN correct? Is the BIC belonging to the IBAN exactly that BIC? It's not trivial. It's even very difficult. National IDs. If you want to pay a small bank in, let's say, in America, which doesn't have a BIC because they're not on SWIFT, for automated transfer, you need to put in the national ID. How do you do that? So you see, in short, there are so many reference data requirements that are so much more than the paper big directory. So, what has SWIFT been doing since around 5 years already? We did a big effort to gather lots of reference data and put that in a big database, which we call SWIFTREF. Yes, all the bigs are in there, and that's not a surprise because SWIFT is the registrar for bigs. There's also the IBAN structures are in there. And from many national banks, we get the national IDs. Plus, we have many standard settlement instructions. Partly, we get them from broadcasts on the network, which is kind of public information. Partly because we've reached out to many banks. And all that is available in a modern, single source in a hyperlinked database for you. So, to give you an idea, because I notice that many banks still think SWIFT is just about the bigs, our reference data. Well, have a look at these numbers. Yes, there are 112,000 bigs, but also 940,000 national bank identifiers for around 180 countries. There are legal entity identifiers, more important for regulatory reporting. But also, you see there 800,000 standing settlement instructions to find the correspondence, etc. IBAN information for more than 70 countries. And that's not only doing payments towards Europe. There are many countries that use IBAN, as I will show you. So all this kind of information is in a way available for you. So, and how is it available for you? Well, I really recommend you to try this product, Bankers World Online. Bankers World Online, there is a free trial for that Swift, on swiftref.swift.com for 2 weeks. No strings attached. It's not that you automatically buy it. We are very reasonable. Try it out. In essence, almost all our reference information is in that online website. And you will never go back to the paper big directory anymore. It has so much more information. For example, institution details, including financials, a credit rating. So even before you go to the KYC process of doing business with the bank, you can already at a high level see the financials. It's already integrated. Payments data overview. So yes, you see their BIC at the top of that little window, but what you can also see, what is their national ID of this bank and their CHIPS ID, etc. So that is in there. And regulatory information, the LEI, if you need to look up, if you find a regulatory report where there is mention of an entity using the LEI, which is more and more an important identifier for reporting. Even India, here in India, is not yet used in the payments world, but you are adopting it, I understand, in the securities world. Is the most important identifier going forward for regulatory reporting, and it's all integrated. So this gives you an idea about what you have there online. Furthermore, so doing payments to IBAN countries. So yes, you see there on the slide, all of Europe, top left, but there are many other countries that use IBAN. Look at the bottom right, like quite a few countries in the Middle East use IBANs. There is Brazil that use IBAN. Now, how do you know which BIC to use? And that is all, has everything to do with having a smooth payment and a good customer service. So if your customer tells you, I need to do a payment to a beneficiary, that's his IBAN, and he's at Deutsche Bank, but exactly which BIC should you use? You cannot always assume it is simply the main BIC in a country. There are many exceptions, and exactly for that, we made a database, which we keep up to date on a daily level. So in this case, so you type in an IBAN in this Bankers World Online. It sees it's a correct IBAN, which is actually the simple thing to do. But more importantly, you find the routing BIC. That's the BIC to send from outside Europe to send the payment to. That is quite useful. And all this information is also available in files. I come back to that for if you want to automate. Standing settlement instructions. I used just one screenshot from Bank of the Philippine Islands, so you can see there. It begins with the Australian dollar correspondence for commercial payments, money markets, or for foreign exchange. That's the categories at the right. You see what their correspondent is, and if you would click on the I for information, you would find the account number. So you can imagine this will save you quite a bit of time compared to always requesting it from your counterparties. So all this information that is online, and I stress it again, do try it out. It's a no strings attached trial. You can have a real idea about the quality of the SWIFT reference data, much more than BICs. Do try it out. Now, if you want to automate, if you want to have this reference data in your systems, well, it's also available as a number of files. And I don't show all the files here, because it's a bit bewildering, really depending on exactly what you need. But most interestingly, there is a product called Bank Directory Plus, which has all the BICs, but also those 900,000 national IDs. To validate IBANs in an automated way, the file is called IBAN Plus. And the file with all the SSIs is called SSI Plus. These are the most interesting ones for you. And indeed, several banks in Asia have adopted these files for better automation. Here, let's show you an example of a record of this Bank Directory Plus file. It is much more than the BIC. So you have there the name of the bank, their address, is a supervised entity, is a head office, is a legal entity. And most interesting there is you also see the national ID, the CHIPS ID, the BIC and the LEI. So all that is in there. The group key is a field that you can use this file to link it with the other files. So all the files are relationally linked. So that is also of interest to have a nicely integrated database. I give you now an example in two slides of the IBAN file. How can you use those IBAN database for automated checking if the IBANs that are used to find what is the correct BIC? Well, in fact, in the IBAN database comes with two files. It comes first with a file that describes for every country how does the IBAN look like. So in essence, the file describes that for Italy, the bank ID, bank and branch, would be the red and the blue numbers together. And there is other information for the account number of the user and the checksum and so, all that is described. But the important thing is the bank ID and the branch ID. And you cannot simply assume that this is the normal national ID. There are too many exceptions. If you naively take the national ID, you will have regularly an error. But that's indeed why you can use the other file, the IBAN plus file, where you can look up that IBAN national ID and find the BIC to send the payment to. So that is how you can use this file in a relatively simple to program way. The SSR file, I loaded it in Excel just to show you as a CSV here. You can see there for all the BICs, for the category commercial payments, wholesale and so on, the currency, what is the correspondent BIC, the account number, possibly there are intermediaries. So this file you can download every month or even every day should you want to. You can download it manually or automatically or via APIs. It's very flexible to have always correct SSIs, 900,000 of them. So that is the that was a bit about the classic files that Swift has, much more than the BICs, to help you with correct payments. Now, I will just end with a few last slides about a recent database. It's called Entity Plus. Entity Plus is a database for regulatory reporting, for monitoring, for surveillance. What do I mean? Well, look at these kind of identifiers. The LEI, I mentioned it already, the more and more important identifier for international regulations to identify both banks and corporates. There is a GIIN. You know what that is, GIIN? It's a FATCA identifier. If you serve American nationals with your bank, you need to have a GIIN because you are subject to the FATCA regulation. And the normal local tax number is there as well. Now, what was our ID? Well, imagine that you read in a newspaper or in a regulatory report, you read something about a certain entity and you want to know, did we do business with them? Depending on the publication, it can well be that it was defined by the LAI or the GIIN. What you can do with our database, they cross-reference it. So this is just an example for ING Bank. ING Bank, you can cross-reference the LAI, the BIC, the GIIN, and the local tax number. So you can easily find, did you do business with that institution? This is the aim of this, this is the first aim of this database. The second aim of this database is building a legal hierarchy. So what are legal branches, head offices in a country, group head, what is the ultimate parent from a legal point of view? This, and what is even the ownership? Is ING Bank NV in the middle at the left is 100% owned by the ultimate parent ING Group, and so on. Well, this part we are currently extending, but you see there the statistics. We have already the ultimate parents for 7,500 financial institutions, that is groups. So Citi would be, the whole Citi Group is a financial institution. But it will become complete for all the connected BICs, parents and ultimate parents in August, and early next year for unconnected BICs. So we are currently still building this database, but really the idea being, not only can you find via cross-referencing an ID that is mentioned in a regulatory report and see if you did traffic with that, but you could also find out, but did we did traffic with an entity that is owned by this institution that I need to investigate. So this is typically how a bank would use the Entity Plus for monitoring and surveillance. So this in essence was briefly, in the interest of time, an overview about the Swift reference data. Much more than just BICs. I stress again, try out the Bankers World Online. You will never touch your paper BIC anymore. Subscribe to it. The link is in the slide. You will get it later. And as a summary, it's information that is worldwide, always from the source, not from third parties. We always get it from the source to be certain it's good. You can have it in different ways. You can have this as a file, as an automated file, as an API call in text or in XML. It's all possible in different ways, or even in FileAct, if you prefer to purely reuse the Swift channel for that. And all these files are interlinked. they all have fields to link to each other, so to make a very nice comprehensive database. Thank you.